reach out to any of the past members who didn't renew in 2019 to ask them about why they chose not to?
Not specifically to that. We did a survey over the summer.
Okay.
I would say, and we sent out to the members a lot of comments about the reduction of hours and the higher membership rates of just calling general complaints of them.
Yeah.
This year, we did intend to return to our normal 2018 operating. So, for example, Hunter's Ridge Pool, we kept open when Hannah Jefferson schools went back into session through the weeknights. I think it was 3 to 8 p.m. and then on Saturdays and Sundays back to the 12 to 8 p.m. through and including Labor Day. So that would be part of, we were planning to do that anyhow. So I just, like I said, the direction from council, if we want to do the lesser of the two, of kind of how we had the family of 3, 4, 5 for our membership rates in 2019 or 2020.
The aquatics, the 2018 had 904 memberships, and it was the revenue was 198,410. And then in 2019, there were significantly less, 774 total memberships, and that was still 198,787. Is that the amount of revenue you need to be sustainable? Obviously, we put more money into that.
If I've misconstrued that this is sustainable in the sense that there is... That
we know that it's not sustainable, but we wanted to know, is this the amount of money you feel you need besides the extra money we have to put in there?
I feel like that's a loaded question there.
Yeah.
These swimming pools are subsidized.
Now, Jeff.
These swimming
you.
Pools are subsidized by general fund dollars. No one could afford a membership if we had to.
No.
So to sustain, yes, our budget for 2020 reflects a revenue of somewhere around $200,000 for the swimming pools, if that's
and of course, we then put extra into that to make
sure
that.
Right, we subsidize
it. We certainly don't want to get it to a point where we're really having to subsidize more than what we are expecting to subsidize.
Correct.
Jeff, is that just membership or is that included in walk-ins?
That's everything.
So that's totally
concessions,
day passes, our own summer camp visitations, it's everything, not just memberships.
So we might have sold less memberships.
And that's why I pulled up this slide there. Our daily visits were, if you will, what saved us, because some people may have, I'll use my own experience of going out to Heat City Pool with my son the first day there, sat there and did the math, I would have to go 10 weeks in a row every Saturday to get my value of that membership there. I'm not going to go every Saturday for 10 weeks in a row to get the value, so I just paid the daily admission fee. So I suspect that some folks did that as well too, with the daily admission fee to say, correct.
One day, one year.
Exactly. So